The worst day of my life. The worst day of my life is on November 26, 2008, when my nana left me here alone. Now let me take you back to the good days. My nana and me did everything together. She took me everywhere she went. I lived with my grandmother my whole life. I have so many good memories with her, but also some bad. All my best days ever is with my nana. One in particular was when me and her, just me and my nana, went to Palm Springs for a church convention. It was so beautiful. We had so much fun. We went to church and we stayed at the most beautiful hotel. I remember that I had nobody to go swimming with, and she was said, "Go on and I'll watch you swim from here." And that's exactly what she did. I kept waving to her. My nana's such a loving, kind, helpful, wonderful person. She did things for anybody. I still, to this day, can't believe she's gone. She was the love of my life. My nana had cancer and she was getting sicker by the minute. The cancer just got worse. I really felt bad because there was nothing I could do to help my nana. I just had to watch her fade away from me. 5 days before the worst day of my life, my mom came to pick me up early from school because of a family emergency. I thought the worst. I thought she was gone, but she wasn't, not yet. When we arrived at the hospital, I saw my nana laying there on the hospital bed, and all I could do was scream and cry. She looked so sick. I just kept crying and crying. I couldn't stop. I couldn't even go in the room anymore for a long time. When I went into the room, I cried. I held her hand and cried. When I couldn't take it anymore, I sat outside the hospital and stared into the valley. I was so depressed. So when I felt I got myself together, I went back in there. I wasn't okay, but I was okay enough to talk to my nana, so I did. I told her how much I loved her, how sorry I was for whatever pain I might have put her through. When I asked her, "Do she forgive me?" I told her to blink, and she did, and she did. I was relieved that she did forgive me, but also very sad that she was leaving me soon. On November 26, I was at home getting ready to go to sleep, and then my cousin called me and told me that my nana had passed. I hung up the phone with her, and I just stared down on my bed and started crying. I couldn't believe that she was gone. Man, I miss my nana so much. Every time I look at her pictures, I always tear up and cry. It's hard living without her. She was my life, my heart and soul. I know my nana is always with me and helping me make the right choices. I know she is in a better place and watching over me. I wrote my nana a letter. "Dear nana, and I miss you so much. I can't see how I'm still living without you. Nana, I am so sorry for all the pain I've caused you and put you through. I'm sorry for all the times I've lied and made you cry. Nana, I love you dearly. You are truly the love of my life. Every time I see your picture, I can't believe you're really gone. Going to church is not the same without you. It's so much I want to say, but words can't even explain. Nana, when you left me, I couldn't function right. I messed up in school and started smoking weed. But now I realize that none of that is the answer. And I know you wanted me to do better than before, so I am now. I stopped everything that wasn't for me, and that was bad. I'm getting good grades and stopped smoking. I'm making both of us proud. It's not a day that go by that I don't think about you. You are my life, and I live for you. I love you, Nana. Love you always and forever, your granddaughter."
You are important to me.
You are.